Hello everybody, this is the Praetorian. This is day two of my podcast or whatever you call this. I'm recording off of an iPad, so please excuse any bad recordings or anything that pertains to my voice and bad grammar, because I'm new to this and I'm trying to get used to recording things. Be basically honest with you, I've pretty much always been an anti-socialist, so I've never really had the experience of talking to people or recording my voice and saying things, so this is a new experience for me. Here lately I have been working on grammar, mostly when it pertains to writing, but I've never really applied that to actual speech. I'm going to start doing that now that I've been editing these recordings and finding out how messed up my grammar really is. Well, with all that said, I'm gonna get on to the topic and what it is I'm gonna talk about. I've been thinking about what my second 10 a.m. Podcast is gonna be about, and I had a lot of thoughts on my mind, but I finally decided that I'm gonna keep to the topic of what I was actually wanting to originally talk about. I'm gonna stick with the environment. At first I was going to get into conversations about the building burning down over in London and things of that nature, but then I stopped and realized, you know, I need to keep my focus on what it is that I'm going to talk about, and later on I can get on to that topic, you know. So today I'm going to talk about the environment and all the things that's been going on and why I believe the way I believe about the whole thing. So with that, let's get on to what I'm going to talk about. Me personally, I consider myself a conservationist. I don't consider myself an environmentalist, and I distinguish between the two because of these reasons. See, a conservationist, they hold life valuable, okay? All life. That means plants, animals, insects, as well as human beings. We believe that it's the best thing in everyone's interest to preserve life. I believe in that, okay? I believe that trees need to be put up when trees are taken down. I don't believe that raping the land of trees is going to be beneficial to the human race. At the same time, I also agree that, you know, when it comes to fish, when people fish, we need to have some kind of guidelines that stops big corporations from using GPSs and helicopters and all these this technology to outsource fishing, where they can fly over the top of the oceans and in the rivers and the lakes and tell boats down in the water, you know, where the big swarms of fishes are, so that they can go out there and take them. With that said, though, I also don't agree with the idea of coming up with laws that literally protect these people and allow them to get away with that, but then it restricts the small fishermen from being able to go out into the lakes and fish for, you know, fish. I think that's bullshit, basically. I don't believe that that's beneficial. I think that that's wrong, and I also think that that caters to the corporations. Makes it easier on them to monopolize. That brings me to the reason why I consider myself separate from being an environmentalist, because see, environmentalists, they from everything that I've been reading about them, I've been doing research on that too, but from everything that I've been reading about them, they are more politically based than what they are scientific or environmental. You take a look at the people that have been involved with the climate change debates, and then you take a look at the history of climate change or global warming, which I find it ironic they've actually started using the term climate change and stopped using the term global warming. Most of the people who say global warming are idiots because they aren't keeping up with, you know, the new information that's coming in about it. Well, anyhow, the people that are involved, you have to look at people like the founder of the Weather Channel. Okay, this man point blank denounced climate change. He was doing it way back in the 80s, all the way up until the year 2001. He kept track of the weather, he kept track of the climate, and he point blank said it's not as drastic as what everybody is saying it is. You also have to take a look at Greenpeace. Now, Greenpeace is one of the biggest supporters of climate change. Now, let's look at them. Let's look at their founder. Their founder point blank denounced climate change. He denounced global warming, and what happened? He was kicked out of Greenpeace. Then he was involved with supporting nuclear energy, which I'm against, okay? I don't support nuclear energy. I don't think that it's a benefit that we can come up with alternative energy sources other than nuclear power. But with that said, I can also say that I do agree with one thing that he said. You know, he said that Greenpeace at one time were scientists. They were activists that went out into the oceans, and they would literally put their boats between a whale and fishermen. And today, they're not like that anymore. The majority of people working for Greenpeace are litigators, they're attorneys, they're politicians, they're people who have turned Greenpeace into politics instead of science itself. I agree with that because I do see a lot of that. I see a lot of control, I see a lot of politics taking place where they want to take away our rights, deny us the right to fish in our own lakes, deny us the right to hunt in our own forests. They want to tell us what kind of vitamins we can take, what kind of health care we can get. It all boils down to globalization. These environmentalists seem to be hard on to the idea of becoming globalist and dropping all borders and making it a one world government, and I'm against it. I don't agree with it. I think that it takes away the rights of the individual by doing that, and from everything I've been reading and everything that I've been seeing, that's exactly what it does. When it comes to Al Gore, the profits that he's been making off of the environmental issue are just insane. When he first got into office in Congress, he started putting together programs that were around the environment. Today, those programs make millions and millions of dollars. He also gives credit to his college professor. I did research on his college professor, and I found out that his college professor didn't even know that he was his student. He went and he started looking, and he also found out that Al Gore wasn't really even that good of a student. He made bad grades in his class. I started checking out his history too, and he was one of the people that started, you know, movements in global warming and, you know, climate change, whatever you want to call it. He started out working for the United States government, after the United States government was done dropping bombs all over the world on islands and in the desert, they had him go in and do research to see if the nuclear energy that was released had caused any damage or made any effects on the environment. And when he did this, he started finding out or doing research about carbon levels in the atmosphere. Well, that got him curious, I guess, because once the government was done with him and he had gotten all that funding by doing it, he had been able to pretty much build his own research facility, which is pretty big, and it's in California. He turned around and he was in the process of starting a college too that's right next to his research facility, and he had lost funding. Well, he had to come up with a gimmick so that he could actually continue his research and be able to get funding. And that is where carbon levels came into play. He began to talk about how carbon levels were affecting the atmosphere, and that really caught the attention of a lot of scholars, and it took off from there. Well, he made a lot of money off of that. He was able to get the funding that he needed. He created his own marina for research. He was also involved in starting a college that, like I said, was right next to it. Later on in his life, when he got older and he was getting ready to pass away, he just point blank denounced climate change. He said that it was a fraud. When he said that, Al Gore ended up going and saying that that wasn't true, that he was senile and he was getting ready to pass away. Well, that made me change my whole way of thinking about it. So today, I prefer to call myself a conservationist and not an environmentalist. I would prefer believing in something that wasn't politically motivated and that was honest and sincere and didn't have entanglements in the government, in policy, in regulations, in telling people how they should or shouldn't live. And that's just the way I feel about it. So if you guys have any kind of comments that you want to make about it, for or against, feel free to make them. I don't ever block or ban anybody from any communities or groups I'm in, pages, whatever. If you guys feel like joining my group or my pages or communities to have an honest conversation about these issues, feel free to do it. That's it for now. Bye.